you got to, the family waiting for conviction. I want your there may be a tear.
First, give an honor to God, head of my life, Pastor Brown, and all of them still good house this morning. Deacon Wright was my friend. We went to breakfast every morning. I don't care whether the rain, shine, sleet, or snow. He would tell me, "You be there, boy." When we go to breakfast and we get out of a meal, we sit down. He said, "You ask a blessing." I would ask the blessing, and I said, "Well, Mr. Darren, you ask the blessing." He would ask the blessing, and through it all, sometimes he'd be talking to me, and I want to get him started. I ain't knowing. He said, "You hear me talking to me?" And you hear me head. But me and Brother Wright stood as friends until the Lord called him home. Labor Day morning, I got up early, and I barbecued. And I went over to see Deacon Wright. When I got there, he was asleep. And I eased in the room and I sat down in the chair. After a while, he woke up and looked over and said, "What are you doing in here?" I said, "I come to see about you because you're my friend." And we talked and we talked and he said, "Well, what did you cook today?" I said, "I barbecued some steaks and some ribs, and I fried a big old cast iron skillet of corn." He said, "You didn't bring me no corn." I said, "You wouldn't eat it if I brought it." He said, "Bring the corn, boy." So the next day, I went on to work, and I got home, and I went down and got my bath, and I come come up and I got the cone out of the refrigerator and I heated up. My wife said, why are you heating it up? I said, I want it to be ready when I get there so you can eat it. When I got back to the nursing home, Deacon Wright was sitting up in the middle of the bed. No lights, no television. He said, what you got in that bag, boy? And I said, I got your cone. He said, well, get me a spoon. I ran around and got him a spoon. He started eating that cone. He said, him good? I said, yeah. He said, this cone sure is good. I said, well, thank you. I said, well, I'm not going to stay here with you all day today. I said, I got some other errands to run. He said, you finna leave me? I said, yeah, I got to go now. When I got ready to walk out the door, I looked back at him. I said, well, you're going home tomorrow. He said, yeah. I said, I'm not going to forget you. He said, don't forget me. I said, I love you. And he looked at me and he said, I love you too. It's hard to find someone to tell you that they love you today. We ought to tell the Lord this morning, thank you. Because it could have been me and it could have been you. But I want to tell the Lord, thank you. Because there's a storm moving this away. To Lori Jean and the Wright family, I love y'all. If you need me, you call me. It's never too late. And it's never too early.
Oh my God.
I love you all.
Yes.
And your daddy loved you all too.
Yes, sir.
Deacon Wright was a good man. Yes. And he loves folks. I'm going to say this and I'm going to get out of the way. Every night when Tab was on, he would call me because he'd come to grab me and he'd teach me. You get home. What did they do, boy? I tell him, he said, that long head cop, he ain't gonna pass the ball. And we'll discuss the game at halftime. It may be 10 o'clock, maybe 11 o'clock. Deacon Wright was gonna call me when the game was over. We're gonna discuss the game like we know what we was talking about. But I love Deacon Wright as he lay there this morning. And I love the Wright family. And Angel's family. May God be with you in peace. Thank you.